Hi, today we are talking about Hund's rule. Hund's rule was proposed in 1925 by a scientist named as Andrej Hund. Why we are doing Hund's rule? Hund's rule is majorly used in atomic chemistry. It is used in quantum chemistry and spectrochemistry also. And it is also very important to predict the ground state of an atom. According to this rule, electron pairing in p, d, and f orbitals cannot occur until each orbital of a given subshell contains one electron. Each r is singly occupied. So, simply we can say Hund's rule is all about the pairing of the electrons. Actually, Hund's rule was proposed after Aufbauprinciple. Aufbauprinciples tell us that the lowest energy orbitals can't fill by electrons first. At first, the orbitals with the lower energy will fill at first, and then the electrons with the higher energy are going to get filled. So the problem with this rule is that it does not tell about the 3 2p orbitals and d and f orbital also, that how we are going to fill them. Because in p orbital, what we have in p orbital, we have three further sub orbitals. Aufbauprinciple was unable to explain how to fill the electrons in that three subshells. Having said that, you can see here, Hund's rule states that before the double occupation of any orbital, every orbital in the sublevel is singly occupied. Say for example, if we have p subshell, the p subshell have further three orbitals. If we need to fill the p subshell, at first we need to fill every orbital with a single electron, and then we need to pair the electron, because the electrons prefer to remain unpaired as far as possible. For the maximization of total spin, all the electrons which are present, they should have the same spin. Why they should have the same spin? For the maximization of the total spin, their spin should be parallel in every suborbital. So by concluding, we can say electron in a subshell are paired when all the orbitals of a subshell is half filled with parallel spin. Then we can pair them. So Hund's rule is basically all about the pairing of the electrons, how we need to pair the electrons, how we need to fill the electrons in the orbitals. So how Hund's rules work for electronic configuration, as we are done with explaining this, that Hund's rule is important for finding out the ground state of an atom. This is all about the energy of the orbitals that was explained by Aufbauprinciple. But the Aufbauprinciple lacks in explaining how we can fill the electrons are going to fill in the further p orbitals, like which orbital should need to fill at first, how many electrons we need to fill in first orbital, how many electrons we need to fill in second orbital, and so on. So this defect of Aufbauprinciple was later on explained by Hund's rule. So here, let's talk about the electronic configuration of hydrogen, as it is the first atom present in the periodic table. The atomic number of hydrogen is equal to 1, so it means it has one electron and one proton also. So 1s, because we have just one electron, so we are just going to put one electron here. As you know, we are just concerned here about the electrons. We have nothing to do with the protons here. So 1s1. So if we are going to draw orbitals, so we are just going to put one electron here. The second atom in the periodic table is helium. The atomic number of helium is 2. It means it has 2 electrons and 2 protons. So 1s2, because in s subshell we can just accommodate 2 electrons. So we need to put 2 electrons here, like this. The next atom that is present in the periodic table is lithium. The atomic number of lithium is 3. So at first, according to the energy level, 1s, then comes 2s. So s subshell have only one orbital. So 2 electrons here with opposite spin. And we are left with just one electron. So we are going to put it here like this. If you're going to do like this, it's correct. If you're going to put like this, it's also correct. Okay, beryllium. The atomic number of beryllium is 4. And then we can see here 1s and 2s. Again, s subshell have only one orbital. So we need to put 2 electrons here and 2 electrons here. Here we are done with the electronic configuration of beryllium. By moving on, after beryllium, we have boron in the periodic table, and the atomic number of boron is 5. So 1 is 2, 2s2, and now 2p is also going to include here because we are just done with accommodating 4 electrons here, and 2p1, 2 electrons here, 2 electrons here. Now p fractional has 3 orbitals, you can see here. Now at first the question arises, if from these 3 orbitals where we need to put this 1 electron? So the answer is very simple. For these 3 orbitals, the energy is same. If the energy is same, so that you can put the electron in this orbital also, in this orbital also, and so far in this orbital also. If I want to write like this, it's still okay. If I want to write like this, it's still okay. If I want to write like this, it's still okay. Generally, we do start from here. So this is the electronic configuration of boron, and this is how we fill electrons according to Hund's rule. The atomic number of carbon is 6. 1s, 2s, and then comes 2p. Now 1s, 2, 2s, 2. Now again 2p, 2. 2s, 2 is 4. 4s, 2 is 6. Now we have 2 electrons. So how are we going to fill them? Do remember, you can fill these 2 electrons in any of these 3 orbitals, but they should have the same spin. If I want to put the electron here like this, I can do so. This is also correct. So it's all up to you how you want to fill these electrons. After carbon, the next atom in the periodic table is nitrogen. The atomic number of nitrogen is 7. So 1s, 2s, 2p. In 1s, we are going to put 2 electrons with opposite spin. In 2s, we are going to put 2 electrons with opposite spin. Now comes p orbital. In p orbital, we have 3 suborbitals, or in p subshell, we have 3 orbitals. So now the 2p have 3 because 2 and 2 here, that is totally 7. So you can put the electrons like this, 1 here, 1 here, and 1 here, because we know electrons preferred to remain unfilled as far as possible. So here till nitrogen, we are done with putting all these electrons in 3 orbitals and they are still unpaired. Now let's move towards the next atom and let's see how we are going to fill the electrons in the next atom. And you can put the electrons with another spin also. It's not going to make any difference. In the periodic table, the next atom is oxygen. The atomic number of oxygen is 8. So here we go. 1s, 2s, 2p. So 1s, 2 electrons here, 2 electrons here. And in the p orbital, again, we have 3 orbitals. In the p subshell, we have 3 orbitals. So we are left with 2 and 2 is 4. 4 and 4 is 8 here. So we have 4 electrons here. So at first, start feeling like this. 1, 2, 3, now 4. Okay, so now you are allowed to pair the electrons because all of the orbitals are already half filled. Now you can put this electron here also. You can put this electron here also. It's not going to make any difference, but usually, generally in the box, we have like this. If we talk about D subshell have 5 orbitals. So what about all these 5 orbitals? At first, fill a single electron in all these 5 orbitals and then pair them, because electron prefer to remain filled as far as possible. Okay, now let's conclude our today's lecture. Today we talk about Hund's rule, and in Hund's rule we came to know about the electron pairing, that how the electron paired in the suborbitals or in the orbital, like in p subshell, in d subshell, and in f subshell. Moreover, we came to know that if we have 3 orbitals in p subshell and if we have 5 orbitals in d subshell, how we need to fill them. At first, we need to fill all the orbitals with the single electrons with the same spin. And the spin can be in any way. It can be in clockwise also, and it can be in anti-clockwise also. It's not going to make any difference. So we need to pair them one by one like this. According to the need of the electrons or according to the electrons that are given in atom, we can pair them like this. So yes, this is all about hund'sruled. It's all about the pairing of electrons. It's all about how you can fill the p orbital. If you want more such videos, please do subscribe my channel as it motivates me to make more new content for you. Thank you very much.